Rumor has it that the new Pixel 10 Pro XL is the new, easiest to repair smartphone on the planet. Easier than even the Fairphone 6, which is wild. Today we're going to find out for ourselves. Turns out that Google has released a free 234-page repair guide. You can print them all out for a bit of light reading, and if this video gets 100,000 likes, I'll read every page word for word like a cozy bedtime story. My goal here today is to keep this smartphone alive, since my last one, you know, it's just nice to see them alive sometimes. I'll drip some isopropyl alcohol around the edges of the glass, hoping that some wicks between the glass and the aluminum into the adhesive underneath to help dissolve it. Then I'll use an ultra-thin pry tool to insert around the earpiece and slowly make my way down both sides, making sure, of course, that my tool does not go deeper than just the black bezel, until I'm positive that I can reach underneath the AMOLED panel, since if something touches the edge of that panel, it'll break the display. The only reason to remove the screen, though, is if it's already broken, so this level of care and precision isn't normally required on a damaged phone. I'm just attempting it with the screen on to prove that it's possible. Which it clearly is, because as you can see with the screen off, there are no additional screws inside the Pixel body. Just a metal latch and a Lego-style ribbon cable that snakes over into the other half of the phone. As long as you don't damage this long ribbon, it's a rather foolproof removal process. My screen is very much still alive, and a sufficiently caffeinated smartphone technician could probably replace a Pixel 10 Pro smartphone screen in about 2 minutes, if they really wanted to. It's an extremely impressive design. If you don't mind using a heat gun, I think this display just won the most repairable smartphone screen of the year. There is a small rectangle at the top that allows the light and proximity sensors to see out through the pixels on the display. You can see my flash shining through the screen. Kind of fun. I'll turn the phone off now that I've proven it can be done. The latch that holds the screen ribbon just slides horizontally out of the way, and then the plug pops off like a little Lego, releasing the ultra-thin screen and its underscreen ultrasonic fingerprint scanner. The rest of the hardware is still in the phone body, but only accessible from the backside. If you remember from this sneak peek during the durability test, Google might have also given us a new, easy way to remove the battery for the first time. I love it when companies do nice things. Speaking of companies doing nice things, I'll pull the SIM card tray out next. This is an international version of the Pixel 10 Pro XL, so I do still have a SIM card tray. The version sold in the US does not. Which isn't all that bad though, since eSIM smartphone plans can be way less expensive, even as low as $5 a month with my channel sponsor Telo. I feel like more people should be talking about how inexpensive these plans are. With Telo, you can most likely still keep your same phone and same phone number, and I'll explain how it works as I try not to break the glass panel. Cross your fingers for me. Telo gives you reliable 4 or 5G LTE coverage without a crazy monthly price tag. It's rather refreshing to see numbers that small again in this economy. Even an unlimited everything talk, text, and data plan is only $25, the first 35 gigabytes of which are high speed, very reasonable. You can change your plan whenever you want, and there are no long-term commitments or contracts, just how we like it. Plus, you get free international calls to 60 different countries, free Wi-Fi calling, hotspot, eSIM, and international roaming. It's a crazy good plan that just sells itself. Then I imagine Telo is able to keep their prices so low by not having any brick-and-mortar stores, and just using dashingly handsome online influencers to let people know their product exists. I'll leave a link for Telo down in the description, and huge thanks to Telo for taking on the big boys and having extremely reasonable prices. Glad I could help more people know they can save money. And would you look at that? The rumors are true. The green pull tab does exist. We'll have to give it a few tugs in just a second, but first we gotta find the battery plug and remove some of the ribbons that are in the way. All the screws in here are a T3, which is nice, but they are all different lengths, so keep them organized and don't sneeze. With the wireless charging cables unplugged, it's cool to see that Google has labeled the Tensor G5 chip, a label that no one would ever see unless you're here subscribed to my channel. Kinda fun. Turns out as well that since Google has added new magnets to the back of the phone, it now cannot reverse wireless charge anymore, like it could on the previous Pixel 9. The magnets mess with the lower powered induction field. I'll remove the 7 visible T3 screws and pop out the substantially large metal plate. This might be what helped add so much strength to the phone during the durability test. There's another 7 screws along the bottom, with another shiny metal plate. This also has a water damage indicator sticker stuck to the top. With the plates gone, we can remove the signal ribbon extension cable. The top of the ribbon has some textured dots. This is Braille for what the heck are you doing in here. Finally, the battery, which, for the first time, appears to be very easily removable. There are no arrows or indicators on which flap to lift up first. There are 2 flaps. And maybe I should have read that manual first, but with some very solid tugs, the green tab lifts the battery away from the lower plastic wrapping that's still left inside of the phone. Not bad at all. Nice work, Google. These lithium batteries are 95% recyclable, so it's nice that we can now remove the 5,200 mAh without exploding. Thumbs up for that. I do have a little extra bracket now though, I'm not sure where it came from. We'll just slide this out of frame and pretend we never saw it. I'll unplug the extension ribbon that connects the main board to the charging port board. This is very similar to the long extension ribbon that extends out the front to the screen. We have one more screw holding down the charging port board. And this guy is a USB 3.2 port that can charge at 45 watts. The little gray rubber ring around the tip helps with the IP68 water resistant rating. Google has also conveniently given us our own little transparent blue window into the balls inside the loudspeaker. Thank you for that. The loudspeaker also has an orange rubber ring and waterproofing mesh over the opening. There's a large rectangular haptic vibrator near the bottom corner. Making our way up to the motherboard and cameras, things get a little more complicated, since there are some hidden screws. Two in the left corners and two more under a metal bracket up at the top. Then the motherboard can lift up and out of the frame, pulling the long screen ribbon cable out through the back as it comes up. We can unclip the camera units from the backside of the motherboard. On the left, we have a 50 megapixel main camera with OIS, then a 48 megapixel ultra wide camera which does not have OIS, and a 48 megapixel 5x optical telephoto, which does have internal optical stabilization. And I'm not sure where this guy came from, nobody saw that. And we have some thermal paste on the back that helps bridge the air gap between the Tensor G5 chip and the copper vapor chamber of the phone. I'm not sure what these mesh strands are for on this other side. It looks kind of like a drywall patch, but it probably has something to do with cooling. Some kind of air gap Google wanted to fill. On the opposite side of the phone, at the top near the upper stereo speaker, we get another window into the ball pit for ants, and a little tic-tac-toe game so technicians have something to do when they're bored. Honestly, I'm a massive fan of what Google is doing with repairability. With the new near foolproof screen removal process, a new removable battery, and most importantly, genuine replacement parts available from iFixit, plus the free repair manual, I think the Google Pixel 10 Pro is on track for the most repairable smartphone of the year, and an excellent choice for a long-term flagship upgrade. Even after everything it's been through, it still turns on and works like a champion. But of course, just like every other smartphone, it always looks better naked. If you want to pay less for your next smartphone bill, check out Tello in the description. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.